Welcome to St. Joseph Academy video classes. This video is all about a geography subject for class 7. We already discussed chapter 1 of geography subject in class 7. Two parts of that chapter is already over. This is the third part of the video. In this video, representation of the geographical features, that is the chapter name. In that two videos is over. This video is the third part, and in this video we are going to study about direction, grid, eastings and northings, grid reference, colors and conventional symbols. Let's start the topics one by one. Just see the topics one by one. First of all, we are going to look at the topic direction. So what is direction? Okay, in a map you will see a vertical line. Okay, like in this map you can see on the right side, at right side you will see the map, and on the map's left side at the top you will find a arrow which is rounded in there in the map. Okay, a vertical line whose uppermost point, you can see that uppermost point with an arrow and a small arrow, and along with the arrow you will find letter N. Okay, this is the north line. Okay, this is the north line which is used to find the direction. Okay, so that means the upper part of this arrow shows the upper direction. Okay, so of the map of the that particular area. Okay, once you got the north direction, you can easily find the east and also west, south, and intermediate direction in between north and east. What is the direction in between north and west? What is the direction? All the northwest, southwest, northeast, and southeast. Okay, you find that what is intermediate directions, isn't it? So here what you find, intermediate direction means in between the major direction, what all the direction you will find, that is called the intermediate direction. So I think you understood what is intermediate direction. Okay, these are north, south, east, west are the main direction. In between some directions you can find, those directions are called intermediate direction. With the help of this north line, you can find north line. You can find north direction easily. Okay, where, which direction you can, you will find the north N symbol, that direction is the north part of this map. Okay, of the any map, not only this map, any map. Okay, so next we are going to look at the symbols which is used in the map. Okay, so some map shows the compass rose, which shows the major directions as well as intermediate direction. Here in this compass row, on the compass which is shown on the right side of the screen, you can see north, south, east, west, and there are intermediate directions also shown over here with a dot, without name. With the dots you can identify wherever you can find the intermediate directions. Okay, so apart from this, you will find one more thing. Map have either north direction or this kind, either this north direction shown in the map, otherwise this compass rose shows in map. It's normally it shows on the upper part of the map. Okay, that means in such a map, the upper part is taken. If it is not shown in the map, either suppose here, you, if you are seeing now, just see that map here. Either this compass or this north line will be there in a map. Suppose this is not there in the map. Okay, neither north line or the compass rose not there in the map. What you will find, upper portion of the map, we will means upper portion here. You can just look at this. Here is one map of India. Okay, in this map, there is no north line or a compass. Okay, not given anything. So therefore, we are taking the upper part of the upper top side. In upper part of the map, we will take as a north direction. Okay, if you are not finding any north line or compass in a map, you have to take the upper part as the north direction. Okay. Next, just showing that the upper part, you have to take it as north. Then once you got the upper part, east you can easily identify, and west you can identify, also south and the intermediate directions you can easily identify with the upper part if you are considering as north. Without north line or compass, but how you can identify the direction, that is what we discussed over here. So now I think that you understood how to find direction in a map. Okay, so next, grid is one of the important thing. Grid, why we are using grid? Grid means it's a symbol to help. What is the use of grid? In a simple way, we can say that to help the locate a feature of on a map, okay, or a particular place, or a particular country, or a particular ocean. Okay, what is the area of the ocean? What is the area of a lake? To locate a particular lake, mountain, ocean, country, or a particular feature, any feature of the geography, any geographical feature, we can easily locate with the help of this grid. Okay, we are going to study what is grid. And a grid is a net of lines that forms cells like graph. Cells like in a graph paper. Okay, you might see in the graph paper, same like every map, there is a lines, cross lines, and all this you can see, like in this picture, how you see the things, same like you will find grid lines. Okay, vertical and horizontal lines you can find. Features on the map can be located by knowing the cell in which cells you can see, you know, how even in graph paper you find cells, same like here also, vertical line and horizontal line together forms, means two verticals, two horizontal lines together form one cell. Okay, so we will study it detail here. Okay, a map that you find in the atlas usually covers several degrees of latitude and longitude. Okay, latitudes and longitudes. Okay, in such map, the grid usually form the meridians and parallels. Okay, so meridians. Okay, this meridians and parallels, latitudes and longitudes. Okay, meridians and parallels means vertical lines, horizontal lines. Okay, now horizontal lines is called parallels. Vertical lines are called meridians. Okay, so latitudes means vertical lines. Horizontal lines are called longitudes. Okay, so these things you have to keep it in mind. Okay, next, you can see that entire world map is divided into certain numbers, lines. Just see that. Okay, so here it is start zero. It's green, from green, which is start zero. So zero, from zero we starting. 0, 32, like that, so many number you will find. Okay, 0 you will find over here, Greenwich. Okay, so this is a small example of the grid, how the grid look like, okay, in a world map. Okay, so each number, whether it is vertical or horizontal, each number carries one, sorry, each line carries one number. Okay, so each line carries one number. Okay, so the number start from the here, from here, Royal Observatory. Okay, the zero latitude, that means from here eastwards and southward number estimates. Okay, so next we are going to see that a topographic map which covers several grids. Okay, we are going to look at that right now. Normally, the topographic maps are covers much smaller area. Okay, most of them cover less than 1 degree of latitude or and longitude. Okay, a small grid only you will find in a topographic map. One grid only. So there you will not find multiple grid numbers in a in a topographic map. Very small area. Normal topographic maps are covering. So they will not find multiple grids. Okay, but in your textbook, there page number 5, there you can find multiple. There also, you is very difficult to find. The normal topographic maps are having only one grid number. Okay, so here you can see that it's a topographic map. Numbers are given here, 0, equator. You can see. Equator. So this is how the grid reference look like. So in this map, there are not enough meridians or parallel to form the grid. So the vertical means north to south line, vertical lines, north to south lines, or the horizontal lines are drawn to form the grid. Okay. These lines are drawn in red. Okay, so here in this map you will find a gray color, and each is known by the two digit number. Okay, you can see that two digit number. Each line is carrying one number. Okay, so here also you can see two digit number is formed. Every line is carrying a number. Okay, so you can see that. So eastings and northings, you are going to find what is eastings and northing. Okay, grid, we understood grid. What is grid? Okay, so grid is, this is grid, the lines, vertical and horizontal line together form the grid, the net. Okay, it's a kind of net. No, so each cell, two horizontal and two vertical lines form a small box. Each box are called a cell. Okay, So we are going to study how we can locate this place. Okay, so places. Okay, so for that, now you have to study one more thing, that is now eastings and the northings. Okay, what is eastings, what is northings? Okay, so the bottom left means in the sense, no, south. If you take one map, okay, you can find different vertical lines, okay, red ones, and horizontal lines, blue ones. Okay, so if you see this south western corner, okay, south, suppose you take one cell. Okay, how to identify one cell number? Okay, that is how what we are looking. Okay, suppose this is a cell. Okay, this is a cell. I'm just drawing the cell with the help of a cursor. You can see that, just look at the cursor movement. This is a cell. Where is my cursor is placed? That is a cell. Okay, two sides you will find the red color, and two sides you will find the blue color. Okay, so here I'm going to, find the cell number. For that, first of all, you have to, each cell carries one number. How to find that? Before that, you have to understand that every cell here, you can see that intersection of the blue line and red line. Red line is easting and blue line is northing. Okay, so the intersection point, this point carries one. This line numbers are the, this line number, okay, what is the blue line number here? 28. And what is the red line number here on the southwest corner of this cell? Okay, that is 40. Okay, we will put together and form the cell name. Okay, like that all the cell, like that all the cell. Suppose this one 41 and 429, like that every cell on the south bottom left corner or south side mein, a cell ka south side mein, or For this cell, south side, west direction, which west corner, western corner we will take, and we will find the intersecting line numbers and formed the cell name. Okay, cell name. Okay, we will study it in detail. Just look at the text with explanation which I given over here. The bottom left corner, bottom left corner, or the southwestern corner of the each cell. Okay, taken as the straight point for the starting point for the numbering of the grid line. Draw on the map. Okay, this is the starting point. From here, we will identify the. This is the starting point of every map, and this is the starting from with the reference of the bottom left corner or southwest corner intersection lines number. We will find the cell name. Okay, so the vertical lines are drawn east to of this point are called. So from this each side, what are the lines are drawn? Towards the east side, what are the red color lines you can see? Vertical lines. Vertical lines from the southwest corner or bottom left corner of this map, all the red lines, okay, vertical lines on or from here, that is called the easting cell. Okay, and from here, northern direction, north direction, you will find some horizontal lines. Okay, some horizontal lines you will find towards the north direction. So that is called the northings. Okay, I think now you understood what is eastings and the northing. Okay, from the bottom left corner or the south here, south western corner of the map, here start the map grids. Okay, so grid lines. Okay, first one, we can see that from here vertical lines starts, and that is in given in this map red color, that is you can vertical lines, that is from the left corner to right corner the number is increasing. So like that the vertical lines are towards the right side. Okay, from left to right, the lines are, you can see vertical lines. Yeah, you can see that is called eastings. From the south western corner or bottom left corner, you will find from there towards the north, you will find the horizontal lines, different horizontal lines, and the number also get increasing when it is moves upwards. Okay, so that lines are called northings. So the number is given to each and every lines, whether it is horizontal lines or vertical lines, whether it is eastings or northings, all the lines having numbers. Okay, so here in this picture you will find 40, 41, 42, 43 are the numbers for the eastings, and a number for the northing, that is 28, 29, 30. Okay, in this example picture, which is given on the right side of the screen. Okay, so now we are going to identify the cell and cell name, all those things. Okay, I want to identify this cell, one cell which is marked with the X. Okay, in a grid, the name of the cell comes from the line that start that form in the southwest corner. We already discussed that thing on the southwest corner of the particular cell, that corner there you will find the intersection of eastings and northings. That intersection line numbers we will take it as the cell name. Okay, so we will study it in detail now. It consists of four digits. The four figure grid reference of all the features shown. That is the grid reference. Okay, suppose here you can see some building symbol is given and one tree is given. With this grid reference, all these things were referred. Okay, suppose you want to find this, suppose this is a post office, then somebody gives you this cell number to identify the post office. Okay. This cell number means how to find the cell number that we are going to look at now. Okay, In this right side picture, you will find that different grid references. Okay, here you can see that 40, 41, 42, 43 is the easting cell on the south west corner. From there towards the right, you will find different lines that is called the eastings. That number is 40, 41, 42, 43, like that. From the south west corner or bottom left corner. Towards the northern direction, you will find some horizontal line that is called northings. Okay, that numbers are 27, 28, 29, 30. Okay, so we are going to identify this particular place, grid reference. Okay, so the place is marked, the cell is marked with X. Okay, X symbol. You have to find this number. Okay, what is first of all, you have to find the south western corner or bottom left corner of that particular cell. Okay, this is the bottom left corner of the particular cell. So what are the vertical and horizontal lines intersecting in this corner? Okay, the line number you can see 41 and 28 easting first. Before that, you have to understand that if you are saying any grid reference, okay, any grid's reference or any cell name, if you are saying any cell name, first we will start with the easting number and then we will say the northing number. So first, what is the easting vertical line number? That is 41. And the horizontal line number, easting means vertical line, okay, and the horizontal line, that is northing, so that number is 28. Okay, so give the number of the eastings forming the left side of the cell. Okay, left side of the cell, this is the easting, so this is number is 41. Okay, then give the number of the northing forming the bottom of the cell. Okay, bottom of the cell, what is the north line number? Okay, that is 28. So first we are writing the easting number, then you are writing the northing number. First you have to write the easting number. If you are giving any grid reference, first you have to write the vertical line number or easting number first, then you have to give the northing number or horizontal line number. Okay, so if it is so, then what is the grid reference of the cell? That is 41 28. I think you got the idea how to find the grid reference, how to give the grid reference or how to find the cell name. Okay, so if somebody says that there is a post office in 41 28 grid reference, okay, then you can see that there is two houses, two building, any of this building might be a post office. Okay, so like that you can identify. Not only this, suppose some other places are given like that. Suppose 20, suppose it is given 27, sorry, it is given 42, 29. Okay, so southwest corner, wherever the 42 line, so this side is a left side of the cell, this is 42 eastings and 29. Not things. Okay, that is intersecting over here. So this cell is 42 29. Okay, so like that we can easily identify the locate the places, easily identify the features of the map with the help of a grid reference. So next we are going to talk about the color. Okay, you will find different maps with the different colors. Okay, so political map, we have certain colors, or physical map, we have, this is a political map. In this political map, on the right side, you can see, this is a political map. In this map, no, countries may use different colors, but no, to show the cities, to write the name of the city, to mark some important cities, we use red and black, and blue color is mainly used for black in political maps. Okay, so countries can use different to identify the country, to mark the country, we can use different colors. Okay, suppose next map is all about a physical map. I will show you one physical map also. This is a physical map of India. In this, no, what are the colors are used? Okay, green color you can see. Blue color, as it is, as usual, normally it shows the water body. And rivers also shown in the blue color. If it is dark blue, then you have to think that there is a depth in that area. Okay, water having depth. Okay, then white part is shows for the capped region, snow capped region. Okay, wherever you there is a snowfall or snow capped mountains, all those areas marked with the white color in a physical map. Okay, shadings are like that. Okay, it is mainly used shadings. Okay, light means lowlands. So in, if you are looking at the land side, lowlands are shown in a green color. A light green color, which is used for showing the plains, lowland area. Okay, so if it is a brown color is used for highland. You can see the brown, light brown to dark brown. That means a light brown means a light brown means a lowest mountains. Okay, when it is dark brown, then means greater heights, like Himalayan part. You just look at the Himalayan part, darkish brown color you can see over here. That means that color having highest, that mountain area have areas are the highest part of this land. Okay, that's why that area is covered with a dark brown color. It is all this area, this is part of Deccan, somewhat higher than the plain, so that is light brown color you can see over this area. Okay, so these things are very important. That blue, as usual, it is water body. We already discussed the rivers also marked in this map with the help of blue color. Okay, so this is all about the physical map. Okay, so in topographic maps, when it is comes to topographic map, normally it carries a small area. Okay, so red color is used for grid lines. In this map, you will find the red color. It is shown because of conversion of the image, and the red color turned into green. So just understand that in your textbook, all the red color it is on page number 5-1 map is given in your textbook. There, the red color is used for grid lines, and grid line number is marked with red color, and roads here, roads are marked with red color. Here, no, the grid lines are marked with some other colors, but usually red color is used for all those things. Roads and grid lines are marked with that. Green color, you can see here, some greenish color, that is forest area. Forest area is marked with the green color. Then yellow color, that area is yellow color is showing in the map. That area we have to think that that area is mainly agriculture land or cultivated land or cultivation happening of all these green color marked areas. Then we have to see the white color. White color land is now uncultivated, no cultivation. It's a free land. Okay, so free land, nothing is happening. Simply, the land is kept like that. Okay, no cultivation, nothing is there. Okay, then blue, as usual, it is a water body. Okay, now most of the maps, whether it is physical, political, or topography, the blue color usually shows the water bodies. Okay, then if the dark color or a black color is used somewhere in this map, that means you have to think that that is mainly used for railway tracks. Okay, telephone lines. Okay, then latitudes, longitudes, and it also marked for dry water bodies. If some rivers are dried out, then that water bodies is marked with the black color. Okay, then brown lines, these are contours. Okay, so brown lines, there is no brown lines in this map. So if there is any contours over here, then that is marked with the brown color. This is all about this topographic map and different colors which is used in a topographic map. So what all things we studied in this chapter? First of all, we studied about the directions. Okay. North line given in the map or compass. Instead of this north, I mean, sometimes you will find compass. Combus rows, if you find north line, you can find N letter is given with an arrow. So that direction is called called the north direction. Once you got the north direction, easily you can find all the other major direction and intermediate direction. This is the first thing you studied. Then next you studied about directions. Okay, in directions you find that it will direction is this direction of a map is mainly we will find with the help of a compass and north line. Okay, so if there is no compass or north line, you can take that north direction. Okay, no, the upper part of the map as the north direction. Okay, so after finding the north direction, you can easily find all the other directions. These things we studied. Okay, so then we studied about the grid. Okay, what is the use of grid? What is grid? A network. A net. Okay, a network. Different cells are there, or cell together form a large network that is called a grid. And each grid cells having a name, and that vertical and horizontal lines which you will find in the world map or the grid. Okay, that is called with the line number. We will find the grid reference to locate the particular feature in a geographical feature in a map. Okay, so then we've studied about northing and easting. Okay, what is northing? From a map's southwest corner or the bottom left corner towards the right side, you will find a number of lines, vertical lines. That lines are called easting. And from the southwest corner of a map towards north side, you will find certain lines. Okay, horizontal lines. That lines are called northings. All the lines, or both the eastings and northing, have each eastings and each northings have number, certain number. Okay, with the help of that number, we will identify the cell. Okay, so for identify the cell, first of all, we will find the bottom left corner or southwest corner of the cell, and there you will find the intersection of the vertical and horizontal line on the left side line of the cell. Left side vertical line of the cell is taken. That means eastings on the left side of the cell. What is the easting number? That is taken as the grid reference. On the bottom line of the horizontal line is taken, and bottom horizontal line and left side vertical line numbers are taken for the grid reference. Okay, so first we will write the easting number, then northing number. There, that's how we will find the grid reference. Then we talked about colors. Different colors are used in different kind of map. What is the use of that color? We studied, and this is all about this video. Okay. Then we will come to another point, that is conventional symbol. Okay, that is the last topic which you are going to talk in this chapter. Okay, conventional symbol. Now, internationally, some symbols are selected to use in a map. Okay, then suppose we are using a particular symbol and other countries using another kind of symbol, then we have to remember all the country, what are the country, different symbols. It is very difficult to study all those things. So in that scenario, we find that all the geography people sit together, those who are creating map, all the people sit together and formed a uniform unique symbol. Okay, for a particular thing, a particular symbol. Okay, internationally accepted single symbol is used for mention certain features of the land. Okay, so that kind of symbol is called the conventional symbols. Conventional, all the countries accepted symbols to use in the map to specify certain features of the ground or certain features of geographical features. a certain geographical features. To show that geographical features in the map, we will use the symbols. We cannot draw the actual picture in the map. There is not enough space in the map. Therefore, we are using this symbols. For that, internationally accepted symbols are there to show schools, to show hospital, to show roads, different kind of roads, to show different kind of roads, to show bridges, to show water bodies, to show a river. All these things, there are certain kind of universally accepted symbols are there. That is called conventional symbols. So all these symbols, suppose in a map, certain symbol is used. Okay, so you can see that on the right side of this screen, you will find a list of icons, okay, all these symbols. Okay, so those symbols, suppose in a map, certain symbol is used. So all the symbols, you will put it together in a table, and that symbols will show it in the bottom of the map. Okay, and its meaning also they will mention in the bottom of the map. While that kind of a table is called the key for that map. Okay, that means all the symbol which is used in that map is given in this key, in that particular key, which you can find most of the maps. It is given on the sideways at the bottom. All they will give all the symbols which is used in that map. While going through that key, you can understand that what are the symbols means in that map. What are the meaning of the what is the meaning of the certain symbol in that which is used in the map. Okay, so you can understand the things very easily. Okay, so that is called the key. And key is not for a one symbol. All the symbols which is used in a particular map. Okay, it will not show all the internationally agreed symbol, all the conventional symbol, which will show only the symbol which is mentioned in marked in that particular map. Okay, for the each and every map, the key will be different. Because suppose one map didn't use much symbol, only the symbols which is used in that map will show in the key. Okay, so that is all about conventional symbol and key. So we are here some points to remember you have to learn. First, a grid, a net of vertical and horizontal lines. We studied that. Then northings, eastings. Okay, the horizontal lines are called northings, and vertical lines are called eastings. Okay, so that's all about this first chapter. If you're having any doubts regarding this chapter or the video, if you are not yet watched the earlier video, please find the video in this YouTube channel. And for the topics which we discussed in this chapter, all the topics we covered, the topic which we discussed earlier, that is available in the earlier videos. Okay, so go through that video also, then only you will get an idea about this chapter. There are three videos we've done for this chapter. So go through all the three videos and make an understanding, better understanding about this chapter. So here I'm winding the this video. Okay, so if you're having any doubts regarding this chapter, you can always contact your subject teacher. So winding up. Thank you for watching.